Welcome to my channel and check out the latest information on Ghost of Tsushima. Ghost of Tsushima is a beautiful open-world action-adventure game set during the first Mongol invasion of Japan in 1274. Adventure of Jin Sakai, our main protagonist, a powerful samurai living in the island of Tsushima, and his transformation as he journeys to free the island and its people from Mongol invaders. The name of the hero that will bear the mantle of the ghost is Jin Sakai. In playing the game, you will become Jin Sakai and make the decision that will lead to the freedom of the island and the defeat of the Mongol army. While going through this journey, you will meet people that will either support or stop you from reaching your goals. You will go through major and minor quests that will reveal and reward armor, weapons, items, and secrets that will help you in your adventure. The first important character you will meet in this game is Shimura, Jin's uncle. He is the lord of Tsushima Island and a father figure to Jin. He took care and trained Jin since childhood in the art of the sword and the traditional ways of the samurai. One of the first most important lessons he imparts to Jin is the honor of the samurai. Jin grows and matures under the guidance of the samurai code of honor. Year passes and Jin becomes a full-grown man, a warrior capable of protecting his homeland. Of course, we will not have a story if Kublai Khan does not appear somewhere in the lore. In the game, his name is Khotun Khan, the intelligent, resourceful and ruthless leader of the invading Mongols. While life in Tsushima moves on peacefully, Khotun Khan was planning the invasion that will drastically alter their lives. He studied and learned the language, traditions and beliefs of this village, and knows which village to tame and which to burn. On the night of the Mongol invasion, Shimura leads the samurai to defend the island. Jin rides with him and provides support to his uncle. They didn't expect the size of the Mongol armada, as Khotun Khan is not just planning for an attack of Tsushima. He wants to claim the entirety of Japan. The battle begins. The samurai were outnumbered and were not familiar with Mongols. Their defeat was inevitable. As though a miracle, Jin survives the night of the invasion and promised to have his revenge, to free his home and his people from the hands of Mongols. But he will not be able to do this as a samurai. He must transform into something that can win against the Mongols, even if it is against the guidance and teachings of his old master. He will give up his honor to achieve his goal. He will become the ghost of Tsushima. The most important historical person and the key character to remember in this game is Kublai Khan. Basically, Kublai Khan wants to conquer every other small country that is not yet part of his empire. Kublai Khan planned for his warships to first invade two small islands that separate Korea and Japan. The first of these two small islands is the island of Tsushima. With that historical background, we can now discuss the premise of the game. What is Ghost of Tsushima all about? What is the hype for? Who wants to play a samurai game slashing your way through feudal Japan? It is about the transformation of a hero who will do everything in his power to defend the people he loves against the forces that try to harm them. It is a universal premise that all of us can relate to, and it does not select a time period, a race, or a culture to become significant. We all know the value of this premise. This hero is determined to do whatever it takes at any cost to defend his people and regain his home. He must put aside the customs and traditions that have molded him as a warrior to create a new path, the path of the ghost, and wage an unconventional war for the freedom of Tsushima. Ghost of Tsushima has a difficulty setting, which you can set before even starting the game. You can also change this while playing. The game has three levels of difficulty: easy, normal, hard, like any other game. On hard mode, this game is fair, but very challenging. The enemies are more aggressive and the player must be precise to pull off extraordinary moves in comparison. Easy mode is for players who want to explore the island, enjoy the flow of the story and still be occasionally tested by a worthy opponent, maybe. No matter which difficulty players choose, the health of the enemies will be the same. It will never be increased. This is to maintain the deadliness of the katana. The combat is about the player's skill. So, the first major combat mechanic is called resolve. Conceptually, it is a measure of the samurai spirit that lets you push through the pain and injury you sustain. The circles are built up during the combat and can be used to either heal up or execute special moves. You will have to decide whether you will save them for healing or for landing a deadly move or do some cool moves with those little circle things. Duels are amazing in samurai films, and Sucker Punch wanted to bring the experience again. There will be a flash of insight, and then the icon will show for the standoff. You can press the D-pad up button on the DualShock 4 controller, and the screen will adjust as though you are in a samurai film with matching dark borders below and above the visible screen. You can parry enemy melee attacks and even projectiles like arrows. Parry the target at the last possible moment to open them up. By waiting to trigger L1 until the attack is about to land, you can change a block into a parry. The attacker will then become easy to counter attack. Also, you will gain some amount of resolve. With a proper upgrade, a new level of success opens up. Press L1 just as the attack is connecting and the parry becomes a perfect parry. This will stun the attacker and leave him open to a special deadly counter move, rewarding a big dose of resolve. The game has a concept called stances, which helps to give you more flexibility in fighting various types of enemies. You can easily switch from one stance to another while in combat. There are two stances, stone and water stance. Each stance is meant to be particularly effective against a specific set of enemies in the game. Switching between stances based on who you face amplifies your deadliness. The stone stance. Stone stance is Jin's ancestral style, the traditional mode of fighting. It was developed to fight other swordsmen, so it will work effectively against Mongol swordsmen. The water stance was developed by Jin as a result of his frustration in fighting the Mongol soldiers. It is very effective for shield-bearing enemies. This combat style is characterized by one-handed attacks, a flurry of vertical and horizontal slashes. The combo of water stance typically has a pattern.